بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وشفيعنا وحبيبنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون في جنات النعيم ثلة من الأولين وقليل من الآخرين على سرر موضونة متكئين عليها متقابلين يطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون بأكواب وأباريق وكأس من معين لا يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون وفاكهة مما يتخيرون ولحم طير مما يشتهون وحور عين كأمثال اللؤلؤ المكنون جزاء بما كانوا يعملون لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا تأثيما إلا قيلا سلاما سلاما وأصحاب اليمين وأصحاب اليمين في سدر مخضود وطلح منضود وظل ممدود وماء مسكوب وفاكهة كثيرة لا مقطوعة ولا ممنوعة وفرش مرفوعة إنا أنشأناهن إنشاء فجعلناهن أبكارا عربا أترابا لأصحاب اليمين ثلة من الأولين وثلة من الآخرين وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يصرون على الحنث العظيم وكانوا يقولون أئذا منا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمبعوثون أو آباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهيم هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون وقال تعالى إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا يوم ينفخ في الصور فتأتون أفواجا وفتحت السماء فكانت أبوابا وسيرت الجبال فكانت سرابا إن جهنم كانت مرصادا للطاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء وفاقا إنهم كانوا لا يرجون حسابا وكذبوا بآياتنا كذابا كل شيء أحصيناه كتابا فذوقوا فلن نزيدكم إلا عذابا إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء أخذ إلى ربه مهابا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا وقال تعالى وجزاهم بما صبروا جنة وحريرا متكئين فيها على الأرائك لا يرون فيها شمسا ولا زمهريرا ودانية عليهم ظلالها وذللت قطوفها تذليلا ويطاف عليهم بآنية من فضة وأكواب كانت قواريرا قوارير من فضة قدروها تقديرا ويسقون فيها كأسا كان مزاجها زنجبيلا عينا فيها تسمى سلسبيلا ويطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون إذا رأيتهم حسبتهم لؤلؤا منثورا عظيما وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ما قال ربنا وخالقنا ورازقنا من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد Respected elders, brothers, friends, I realize you've been sitting here for a very long time. It's amazing, it's a miracle. Children are sitting so quietly, mashallah. So many children in one place, listening attentively. It's a miracle. Hazrat Ji Maulana Inamul Hasan Sahab, once talking about ladies, the ladies can't keep quiet, they all have to talk. They have to be busy in talking, conversation. So Hazrat Ji was asked, Hazrat Ji once asked people that if someone asks you what is the biggest lie, greatest lie a person can lie and fabricate, then you should say that if a person says two women were sitting and they were quiet, then that's the greatest lie. When women sitting together, they have to talk. Similarly, when children, they have to make noise. But alhamdulillah, all children over here sitting so quietly, patiently, very nice to see that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all the children. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakah in all the children who participated, who won prizes. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the pious coolness of eyes for their children, for their parents. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the masjid and madrasa running for a long time. Give good reward to the asatiza, the committee members, everyone who works hard behind these young children to nurture them, to bring them up in the best possible environment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept their efforts, reward them in full in this world and in the hereafter. Respected elders, brothers, friends, today's topic is Jannat and Jahannam. MashaAllah, the young people spoke about Jannat and Jahannam, they've done my job. Maulana Sahab prepared them very well. Briefly, but beautiful description of Jannat and Jahannam was given. I recited to you some ayat. We can't go into the tafsir and meaning of detail, tafsir of every ayat. However, we will try to cover a few points. First of all, we need to talk about Jannat and Jahannam. Because we as Muslims believe in Jannat and Jahannam. Do we believe or do we not believe? Hands up who believe in Jannat and Jahannam? MashaAllah. Alhamdulillah. Everybody sitting over here believe that Jannat is there, Jannat is there, Jahannam is there. And we have to keep talking about it. Otherwise, we could forget it. We could lose track. We could go on some other track. Allah forbid, Allah protect us. There are people out there, there are forces out there who are leading us to believe that there is no Jannah, there is no Jahannam, there is no such thing as heaven, no such thing as hell, no paradise, and no all this talk about Jannah, Jahannam is just fiction, it's just gossip, there's no reality, nothing behind it. They make movies of this type, in which they make fun of Jannah and make fun of Jahannam. They make the people of Jahannam look like better off than the people of Jannah. That the people of Jannah in paradise are so up to date and this and that and picked up, whereas the people of Jahannam are enjoying themselves. In Italy, one of the churches, huge massive church, you go and as you enter on one side, there is the wall is covered with the picture of paradise. And the other side, the wall is covered with the picture of hell, Jahannam, heaven and hell. When tourists go inside that church, very few people look at the paradise, most people look at the hell. Because their mishaj has become such that they love looking at hell and Jahannam. And they just admire, oh, this is so nice, this picture, this drawing is so nice, paradise, oh, it's okay. So this is the type of mishaj and mood that is being programmed into our brains, our minds, and into the brains of our young ones, our children. This is why there is great need to talk about Jannah, talk about Jahannam, so we can understand the reality and our belief can become strong, we can strengthen our yaqeen. This is why our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من شهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأني رسول الله وأن عيسى عبد الله وابن أمتي وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه وأن الجنة حق وأن النار حق أدخله الله الجنة على ما كان من العمل. Whosoever testifies that there is no God besides Allah, and Muhammad is Rasul of Allah, and Isa is the slave of Allah, and he is the son of Amatullah, Maryam alayhi salam, and he is the word of Allah, and he is the special ruh and soul from Allah, and he testifies that Jannat is barhaq, true, and Dozakh is barhaq, true, Allah will admit him into Jannah in spite of whatever actions and deeds he has. Subhanallah, so great basharat and virtue for saying this kalima. Say it with me. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu wa anna Isa abdullahi أمته وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه والجنة حق والنار حق. إن شاء الله Allah will admit you into Jannah. This is guaranteed by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the hadith of Sahih Muslim. You testify this from the depth of your heart with firm conviction, yaqeen, Allah will take you into Jannah, inshallah. So we have to have belief in Jannah and we have to have firm belief in Jahannam. There should be no shak, no doubt, no suspicion and no niggling feeling with regards to Jannah and Jahannam. Don't watch such movies which create that doubt within your mind. Movies like The Demolition Man, which makes fun of Jannah and which makes fun of Jahannam, which is the most violent movie to be made. There was a survey some time ago in Times. More movies now, I did this survey maybe a few years back, 5-10 years back. And in that survey it said the most violent movie is The Demolition Man and the most violent cartoon is Tom and Jerry. Because they both attract you to violence, shooting, killing, murdering, and that is why it's called, you know, fighting, beating someone up. This is why the most violent cartoon was Tom and Jerry and the most violent film was Demolition Man. And that film makes fun of Jannah and it makes fun of Jannah. So these types of movies, they weaken our iman. They create doubt and suspicion and shak within us. We should not watch these types of movies. May Allah give us tawfiq to understand. Respected elders, brothers, friends, Jannat and Jahannam are barhaq. What is Jannat and what is Jahannam? We learn from Quran and Hadith. Bismillah. learn from Quran and Hadith that Jannat and Jahannam is nothing but another form of the deeds, actions we commit in this dunya. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes in Mi'raj. He is returning. He meets Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam on the seventh heaven sends a message for you and me. Tell your ummah, أَنَّ الْجَنَّةَ قِيَعَانُهُ وَأَنَّ غِرَاسَهَا سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ. Tell your ummah that Jannat is a plain field, and the trees to be planted in there are Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allah. Every time you say Subhanallah, a tree is planted in your Jannah. Every time you say Alhamdulillah, one tree is planted in your Jannah. Allahu Akbar, one tree planted. La ilaha illallah, one tree is planted. Which means the trees in Jannah are nothing but your Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Tasbih, which you used to do in this dunya. One example, your a'mal, whatever you get in Jannah will be something, another form of your a'mal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will change that, give it a form, and give you in the form of mansions and palaces and luxuries and fruits and trees and whatever you get over there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. So, in Jannah, your a'mal will be given another form, that is what your Jannah is. Similarly, in Jahannam, if you have fire, snakes, scorpions, and azab, and punishment, and torment, and this is what you have committed in this dunya. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sees a long dream in which he is shown some scenes. First scene is, he sees a person sitting, another person standing over him with a hook in his hand, and he puts that hook in his jaw, pulls it back, tears it apart. Then he goes on the other side, puts the hook in his jaw, tears it apart. Meanwhile, the other side is cured, and he comes to the other side and tears it again, and again, and again. This azab is being given. What is this? They say, move on. Malaika, angel, Jibreel, Mikael, over here. He sees another scene. A person is lying down, and another person with a boulder in his hand, and he hits him and smashes his head and goes to bring that stone back, hits him again. What is this? Move on. He sees a tanur. The opening is narrow and inside is very wide. There is fire and there are naked men and women. When the fire blazes up and the flames rise, they also come up, try to get out, but they can't. They're screaming and they have to go up, down. What is this? Move forward. He sees a river full of blood, stench, smell coming out of it, stickiness in there. A man is inside. He tries to come out. But there is another person standing on the riverbank. He has some stones. He takes one stone and hits him on his chest and he goes flies back inside. He attempts to come out again and again. He hits him and he goes back inside. What is this? Move on, I will tell you later. And then they go and show him a nice, beautiful garden in which there is a huge tree and a person sitting, leaning with the tree, small children around him playing. And they move on and they say, climb this hill, and they see a beautiful palace. They go inside and they see some men, women, young, old, children. They are inside the palace rejoicing. They say, come on, come to another hilly area, another beautiful mansion, and that is more beautiful than the first one. And then they see some men and some young and old men in there, and they come up down. He asks, what is all this? And they say, the first person you saw was A person who had a habit of telling lies, fabricating lies, used to lie and used to create so many lies and fabrications that it would reach from one corner to the other corner. So, because he used to lie with his mouth, he is punished with his mouth. The second person you saw is a person who was given Quran, who knew Quran, who memorized some parts of the Quran. However, by night he wouldn't read the Quran and by day he wouldn't practice on the Quran. So because his Quran was in his memory brain and he learned it but he didn't practice on it, he didn't pray, he never even prayed Fajr Salah, never prayed Tahajjud Salah, he was lazy. Because of that, he is being punished. And the third scene you see, the fire, they were the people who used to commit zina, fornication. Because they used to fornicate in the dunya, they used to watch pornographies, movies, pictures, films, and they used to create excitement and generate that passion within them. That fire of excitement which used to build up within them. And then they used to release that tension through zina and fornication. That same fire got there in the form of the fire of Jahannam. And they are being punished in that same fire. It's nothing but their excitement which they built through that of watching these types of things and the excitement which they build up within them. And explaining the hadith according to our environment. In those days, there were these things, meaning people used to watch, half naked women or maybe something mushrikeen, and these things used to happen. So Rasulullah is referring to that. And the fourth scene you saw about the river of blood was of a person who used to take interest from people, usually, who used to consume interest. Nobody knows, so let me take interest, eat it up. Because he used to suck the blood of people in the dunya, that same blood gathered over there in the form of the river, and he is being punished in that blood which he sucked from people. A person pays loan and interest on there for 25 years. He's paying that debt and paying and paying. His 25 years of life is wasted. His hard work, money with his blood and sweat, he gives it to that other person. So the person is sucking his blood. So that person who took interest from him, who sucked his blood, that same blood is over there and he is being punished. And that man you saw was Ibrahim alayhi salam. The children were the young children who died in the infancy. And the first palace you saw is a sample, a model of the mansion which will be given to the believers, to the righteous people on the day of Qiyamah when they come to Jannah. And the second palace you saw was the palace of the Shuhada, those who give their lives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is your mansion you see over there. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, let me go there. They said, no, your soul is still inside your body. You will be able to see it after you come up, after you come in. So we learn from this that in the akhirah, Jannah, Jahannam is what we make our Jannah and Jahannam. If we do good deeds over here, we are misbehaved and sin over here, we are making our Jannah. Amal hi se banti hai zindagi. Amal hi se banti hai zindagi. Jannat bhi jahannam. Ye khaki apni fitrat mein nanuli hai na nani. Your amal will make your jannat and your bad amal will make your jahannam. So, we understand from this that jannat and jahannam is another form of whatever actions we commit, we do over here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it form. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring it on the day of Qiyamah, weigh in the scales, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us for the good deeds, actions we have committed. In one hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when a mu'min dies, then his pious deeds, his good deeds, his actions, come to his qabr, inside his qabr, in the form of a nice, beautiful man. And they sit with him, talk to him, and they give him peace and sukoon inside the qabr. So that a'mal will be given some form and they will be brought over there. This is what we learned from Quran and Hadith. So, this is Jannah. Now, we move on to some description of Jannah and some description of Jahannam. What time of Jannah and Jahannam will be given? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained Jannah and Jahannam in Quran, and He explained it in Tawrat, Zabur, Injil, and in the scriptures that were given to Adam alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, and other prophets. So you will find description of heaven and hell, Jannah and Jahannam in the previous scriptures as well. Based on those scriptures, people try to make their own Jannah in this dunya. Like Shaddad. Shaddad was a tyrant ruler. Looking at the scriptures before him, he made his own Jannah in this dunya. That Allah has promised to give me this Jannah, I will make my Jannah in this dunya. He was a millionaire, billionaire, he was a king of his area like Firaun, Haman. And he made his Jannah. He gave the description, the whole palace was built. Construction was going on, everything was ready. And he called upon people and he made a huge feast. And for his party, for his Jannah. He got ready and he came. However, when he came to his Jannah, he put one foot inside and the other foot was still outside. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Malakul Maut to extract his soul, and his soul was extracted. He fell there, and then he couldn't utilize and use his Jannah which he made for himself in this dunya. Maybe Allah did this because He was trying to make fun of the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So people try to make their Jannah in this dunya. You can't make Jannah in this dunya. This, the world of this dunya is temporary. The luxury of this life is only for a limited time, a short, brief period. After that, we all have to go from here. No matter how much you spend on your mansions, palaces, okay, we have to live in a goodly manner, good house, good place, good dwelling, nice car, nice clothes. Nobody says you shouldn't. But however, we should not be extravagant, and we should not try to make our Jannah in this dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, inshallah, give us Jannah when we go over there. We should prepare for that Jannah. That is a Jannah we should be aiming for and we should be striving for and working hard for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us a description of that Jannah in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, in Surah Al-Rahman, in Surah Al-Dahr, in Surah Al-Naba, in many, many Surahs of Luqman. First of all, what is the condition of Jannah? Of going into Jannah? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُولًا. Those who have iman and amal salih, righteous deeds, good deeds, for them are Jannatul الْفِرْدَوْس, as a hospitality. Allah will offer it as a hospitality. وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَرِيمًا, noble reward. We will have done small, minute, futile deeds, not worthy of placing in the court of Allah. But Allah, through His karam and grace, will accept our deed and He will reward us many, many times, many, 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 many folds from what way we have. Immense reward will be given. We will never be able to, you know, grasp that. Oh, so much reward for me. Oh Allah, I don't deserve all this. Where did all this come from? Allah said, this is from me. Take it. The hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, The smallest Jannah that will be given to a person will be 10 times larger than this whole world. You see this ball? Ball? This ball. Allah's Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the smallest Jannah will be 10 times larger than this dunya. Just imagine how the loftiest Jannah will be, the highest Jannah will be. The people in the lowest Jannah will look at the people in the highest Jannah like the people of the earth look at the stars. That's how much gap there will be between the Jannahs. Jannatul Firdaus. Jannah has 8 different gates and different meanings mentioned in the Quran. Jannatul Firdaus, Jannatul Ma'wa, Jannatul Adn, Jannatul Na'im, Darul Khulud, Darul Muqam. These are all the names of Jannah, Darussalam. So these are various Jannah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهِ فَاسْأَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ فَإِنَّهُ أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَأَوْسَطُ الْجَنَّةِ وَأَوْهُ عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَانِ.
When you ask from Allah, ask Him for Jannatul Firdaus. Because that is the most highest Jannah and the best Jannah. And above it is the Arsh of Rahman, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when the more a thing is closer to the throne of Allah, the more beautiful it will be. The further it is away from the Arsh of Allah, the lower it will be. So the closest Jannah is Jannatul Firdaus. When you make dua, ask Allah for Jannatul Firdaus. May Allah give us all Jannatul Firdaus.
Amen.
عندها جَنَّةُ الْمَأْوَى إِذْ يَغْشَى السِّدْرَةَ مَا يَغْشَى جَنَّتَانِ مِنْ فِضَّةٍ آنِيَتُهُمَا وَمَا فِيهِمَا وَمَا بَيْنَ الْقَوْمِ وَبَيْنَ مَنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَى رَبِّهِمْ إِلَّا رِدَاءُ الْكِبْرِيَاءِ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ فِي جَنَّةِ عَدْنٍ. Jannatul Adn is mentioned over here. Jannatul Iqama, where you will stay for eternity, with eternity, forever and ever. That life is life of eternity. We want to live in this dunya forever. But Allah said, no, this dunya is temporary. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا. Ever and ever. A person might ask question, will people not get fed up in Jannat? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered that question in Surah Al-Kahf as well. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا لَا يَبْغُونَ عَنْهَا حِوَلًا. They will not want to move from there. They will like so much that they will want to stay there forever and ever. So these are the names of Jannat, various types of Jannat. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us description of two Jannats in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, also in Surah Al-Rahman. In Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Allah said, وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. Those who will be rushing toward the Jannah, who will be running, who will be going through the fast track, who won't have to go through the lengthy procedures of Maidan al-Hashr. The lengthy procedures, many, many years people will have to spend to give their account. If you are a businessman and the taxman comes to your place for your accounts, then the amount of business you have, that's the amount of time you will spend in your property. He might have to come for 3-4 days, 1 week, 2 weeks. He might have to go through all the papers. Small business, he would finish in a few hours. Similarly, on the day of Qiyamah, some people's account will be very lengthy. They might have to stay there for 1,000 years in Maidan al-Hashr to give an account of their whole life. There will be others who will only remain there for a brief period. And there will be others who will have no account to give. They will be pious and clean. And for the Maidan al-Hashr and their standing before Allah will be like a person praying 2 rakat salah. It takes you a few minutes. So they will stand in Maidan al-Hashr for a few minutes and straight through the fast track into Jannah. These are the sabiqoon as-sabiqoon. أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ. These are the ones who are qareeb and nigh and very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. They will be admitted into the gardens of ni'mat and blessings of Allah. ثُلَّةٌ مِّنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنَ الْآخِرِينَ. A huge portion from the first and a few from the last. This is of this ummah. This ummah, ummah of Muhammad, Allah is saying, a huge portion from the first, meaning the Sahaba, Tabi'een, Tabi'i Tabi'een, Khayrul Qurun. Among them will be many, many Sabiqeen and Awliya Allah. They will go through the fast track into Jannah. Of the later generations, after them, there will be few. Few Awliya Allah who come later on, and they will also join the Sahaba and the Tabi'een and the great Awliya Allah of going into Jannah with haste. Ala sururin mawduna. They will be reclining on couches and sofas which will be woven with golden threads. Mawduna. Meaning the thread of this dunya is normal. But over there the sofas will be made with golden thread and golden brocade. Ala sururin mawduna. Muttaqeena alayha mutaqabileen. Beautiful couches, huge massive sofas. And they will be reclining on them, facing one another, face to face. Friends, like you have your friends over here, you sit facing one another, you enjoy your party, you enjoy your dinner, you enjoy your food, you enjoy your fruit, sitting on the round table in your homes, in your mansion, in your palace. So they will be facing one another. مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَيْهَا مُتَقَابِلِينَ يَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانٌ مُخَلَّدُونَ. They will go around them, young boys, who will be remaining with them forever. Meaning for their khidmat, service. They won't have to go around like we have our kitchen and we have to look for this and look for that. They won't have to go around looking for anything. They will just be reclining on the sofa and everything will be brought to them at one ishara, at the point of a finger. Bring this and it will immediately come to them. In fact, Shah Abdul Aziz Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullahi writes that the connection between a jannati and the ni'mat of Jannah will be similar to the connection between a person's brain and his limbs. As soon as my brain instructs my arm hand to move this side, it will move. Look that side, it will look. The eyes will obey the brain. The ears will obey the brain. The tongue will obey the brain. The hands, the feet, the mind, everything will do what the program, the brain says it to do. Similarly, in Jannah, you will have the ni'mat, you will have the tree, full, laden with fruits, and you want to eat some fruit, you think about it, immediately the branch will come closer, you can take as much as fruit as you want, and it will go back to its place. You want to eat something, drink something, the birds will be flying. And you want to eat the meat of a bird which is flying, you think about it, and that bird will immediately come to you. You can take as much meat as you want, and you can make kebabs and burgers and samosas and whatever you want, and enjoy. You will want to drink some wine, and there will be four rivers flowing in front of every jannati's jannah. His mansion, huge, massive palace. And you want to drink something, these yakufu alayhim wildan mukhalladun, they will immediately rush and bring you jugs, goblets filled with all those water, honey, milk, and the wine of Jannah. Whatever you want to drink, however much you want to drink, you can eat as much as you want, you can drink as much as you want. This is yatufu alayhim wildan mukhalladun bi akwabin wa abariq wa ka'sin min ma'in. Bi akwabin with cups and abariq, goblets and jugs. And waqasim ma'in, and glasses of flowing wine. That wine will not be like the wine of this dunya in a small bottle. It will be, the river will be flowing in front of you. And la yusadda'un anha wa la yunzifun. You will not get headache from that wine, nor will you get intoxicated from that wine. In this dunya, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says that in this dunya, you drink the wine of this dunya, the alcohol of this dunya, first thing is you get headache. And then your mind is intoxicated, you become pagal. And then you get sickness feeling and you feel like vomiting. And the fourth thing is you urine a lot, you pass water a lot. These are the four side effects of the wine and alcohol of this dunya. You get headaches and you get mad insane and you start vomiting, sick feeling, and you pass water and urine a lot. This is the four effects of the alcohol and wine of this dunya. However, Allah said, لَا يُصَدَّعُونَ عَنْهَا وَلَا يُنْزِفُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed that effect in the wine of this dunya, in the wine of Jannah. Allah will take that effect away, and you can drink as much wine as you want. And it will be sweet, beautiful, tasty. يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ خِتَامُهُ مِسْكٌ وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافِسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. They will be given to drink from the wine which has been created by Allah and the seal has been put upon it and it's been reserved and placed for them already from now. Mir rahiqin makhtum. Wine is such a thing that the longer period you keep it for, the better it tastes. So Allah has made it already now for you. It's ready for you. And the cork on the bottle of that wine or whatever Allah will make for you, mir rahiqin makhtum, khitamuhu misk. And that will also be the top and the lid of those bottles will be made from musk, so that the fragrance of that wine will also have the fragrance of musk. This is وَكَأْسٍ مِّن مَعِينٍ لَا يُصَدَّعُونَ عَنْهَا وَلَا يُنْزِفُونَ and وَفَاكِهَةٍ مِّمَّا يَتَخَيَّرُونَ and fruit of their choice. You will have fruit of your choice. كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرة رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأتوا به متشابها. You will get whatever fruits you want. You go to some place in Dawat and you are brought lots of fruit. You like it. There's apples, there's oranges, there's bananas, there's grapes, there's strawberries, there's cherries, there's kiwi fruit, there's mangoes, and there's melon and watermelon. Different types of fruit. You love fruits. You want to eat as much fruits as you want, and we should eat as much fruits as we can. So over there, Allah said, وَفَاكِهَةٍ مِّمَّا يَتَخَيَّرُونَ. You will be given fruits of your choice. You can eat whatever fruit you like, it will be available for you. وَلَحْمِ طَيْرٍ مِّمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ. And you will get the lamb and the meat of birds which will fly. We meet is Sayyidul Idam, is the leader of all what you call of all foods. You know, without meat we can't survive. We have pity for the vegetarians. They don't know what they're missing. Kebab, burgers, whatever, you know, you go on the takeaway, you find beautiful, these tasty things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it for us to eat. Why become vegetarian and say, oh, I'm not going to eat meat? You're missing out. Allah created that animal for you to eat. So Allah will give you beautiful meat of tasty birds. Chicken is a bird. We like chicken, we like quails, we like other pheasant, other birds. No, and the bird's meat tastes very tender and very nice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you bird's meat over there. And those birds are not birds of this dunya. They are the birds of Jannah. They have been created in Jannah. They are grazing around in Jannah. They are eating from the wild fruits or berries of Jannah. And from Jannah. So their own bodies, their meat will be really beautiful and tender as well. Over here in this dunya, you must have heard stories of the rulers of Afghanistan, like Babur Bashar and those, how they used to eat the best of bakras, best of goats. And those goats were not fed grass. They were fed with badam and pista and kaju, almonds, pistachio. But from the bird, from his birth, it was given almonds and pistachio, and that is why its meat was tender. And when it was brought to the market to sell, it would have special flowers around its neck. And the goat would also be chuffed and sitting there, and it would go for its weight in gold. That's how much price they would get for it. So these types of, you know, meat, fresh meat, beautiful, tasty, lazeez, tender. وَلَحْمِ طَيْرٍ مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ. And on top of that, وَحُورٌ عِينٌ. Aha, غرون عین میں مزہ ہی ایسا ہے وہ ایک جگہ میں نے جنت کا بیان کیا سب کچھ بیان کیا پتہ نہیں میں کوئی شرم کے مارے غرور کا بیان نہیں کیا تو بعد میں کوئی کہہ رہا تھا مولوی صاحب وہ غرور تو رہ گئی وہ بیان نہیں کیا آپ نے کہا یار بات تو صحیح ہے میں نے سوچا میں کوئی ادھر ادھر کا بول لوں گا اس لیے میں چپ رہا میں نے غرور کا نہیں دس کیا ویسے یہ حور وحور عین فیئر کلرڈ لیڈیز بیوٹیفل اسکن وتھ بیوٹیفل آئیز. The beauty is in the eyes. The beauty is in the eyes. You look at a person's eyes, you can realize their beauty. Because large eyes with beautiful pupils, a beautiful color, they look nice, they make a person look nice. Gorgeous, beautiful, handsome. That is why Allah gave the description by only the color and the eyes. The color of their body and their skin will be fair, beautiful, nice, white, beautiful color. And their eyes will be nice, beautiful, large, good-looking, handsome, gorgeous. And Allah said, "Kamthali lulul mukminun." They will be beautiful. They will be fresh, and taza and patar, like kamthali lulul mukminun, like the diamonds and rubies, which are fresh, just taken out of the shell, from the ocean. There is no dust on it. Just been taken out of the ocean, and you take it, break the shell, take it out, and it's gleaming, shining. And there is no dust over it. It's beautiful, fresh. Allah said, they will be looking as beautiful as that time. Jazaan bima kaanu ya'malun. This will be a reward for what the sabiqeen had been doing in the dunya. Wahurun a'in, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, وَلَوْ أَنَّ امْرَأَةً مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ اطَّلَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ لَمَلَأَتْ مَا بَيْنَهُمَا رِيحًا وَلَنَصِيفُهَا عَلَىٰ رَقْصِهَا خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. If a woman from the women of Jannah was to peep in this world, then her fragrance would spread fragrance throughout the whole globe, throughout the whole world, from east to west. And in front of the nur, in other words, in front of the nur of her face, the shine, the nur of the sun would fade away. Like when the sun comes out, the stars and the moon fade away. So if she was to appear in this dunya, she would have so much nur and light on her and beauty on her that the sun would look pale in front of her. And the urni which she will be, the headgear which she will be wearing, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's made from beautiful special silk, and it's so precious that the treasures of the whole world cannot pay. be the price of that gold ring or that headgear which she will be wearing on her head. So, حُرٌ عِينٌ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ زَوْجَتَانٌ يُرَى مُخُّصُ قِيمَةٍ مِّنْ وَرَاءِ اللَّحْمِ. In one hadith, that every Jannati will go in Jannah, every Jannati will get two such حُرَئِينٌ that they will be so beautiful that the marrow of their bone will be visible from behind the clothes she will be wearing and the meat and the bones, the flesh. She is so beautiful, just like if some real nice red drink in a bottle, and if there is something inside it, you can see the glass bottle, you can see the red drink, and you can see something else that is put inside as well. So similarly, her beauty will be so much that you could see the inside, if you wanted to, the inside of the marrow, that is how beautiful she will be. These are little bit of description which our Rasulullah gives us with regards to the rule and the women of it. And they will be beautiful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Rahman, وَعِنْدَهُمْ فِيهِنَّ قَاصِرَاتُ الطَّرْفِ لَمْ يَقْحِشْهُنَّ إِنْسٌ قَبْلَهُمْ وَلَا جَانٌ. That they will always lower their gaze. In spite of their beauty, they will have no pride, no arrogance, no desire for anyone else. Unlike the beauty queens of this dunya, who if have a little bit of good color and they will they start showing their beauty. And you know, flirting to people and running after here and there and trying to attract people. Allah said, قَاصِرَاتُ الطَّرْفِ. They will always lower their gaze. They will not look at anyone other than their gender. They will say, so طُوبَى لِمَنْ أَحْيَانَا لَكَ وَأَحْيَاكَ لَنَا. Alhamdulillah, alladhi ahyana laka wa ahyaka lana. That all praise is for Allah who created you for us and us for you. They will not go out of their jannah wandering around window shopping or Christmas sales. No, they will be in their own homes and they will only look at their own jannati and no one else. Qasiratu al-tarf. Lam yatmithhunna insun qablahum wala jann. No human being or jinn will have touched them before the Jannati arrives over there. He will be the first person to touch them. Someone asked, Ya Rasulullah, will we have intercourse in Jannah? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, of course, a person will go around 100 virgins in one day. Is there, what is the Huri in for? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, because in this dunya there is no pleasure better than the pleasure of intercourse. There is no food, no drink, no desire, no other clothes, no car, nothing like the pleasure we derive when we fulfill our need. So if Allah does not keep that pleasure in Jannah, then what good is the Jannah? What good is the hood? So Allah, and ajeeb, amazing, in some ahadith it says Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam explaining beautiful manner that when a person sleeps with his partner Hurayim, and afterwards when he goes back, she will become virgin again. Every time he goes to her, she will be a virgin. And there will be no tawalud and tanasul, no procreation, reproduction in Jannah. Someone asks, Ya Rasulullah, will we have children in Jannah? And Rasulullah replied, no, you won't need any children in Jannah. Children are needed because you are scared when you die, who's going to survive you, who's going to inherit you. When you grow old, who's going to help you, who's going to support you. There is no old age and there is no need for reproduction, inheritance in Jannah, so there is no children in Jannah. So Hur-e-Een, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you beautiful Hur themselves, and they will be your khadimas, nokranis, and khidmat guzar. Now when this subject is normally mentioned, our ladies get a bit jealous. And they say that, if you get Hur-e-Een, what are you going to get? So we will tell them simple answer. These rules which we are talking about are your khadimas, your nokranis, your attendants, your servants. So imagine how the queen will be. You will be the queen of Jannah. And these will be under your command. The Jannati will not go to them without your permission. So you will have the upper hand, you will have the control over everything, you will be the queen of Jannah. Therefore, you shouldn't feel that actually what it is, if we put our environment of today to one side, and we look at the nature of the structure of man and woman, keeping the whole world in perspective, we will see that man has been naturally created, programmed as polygamous, whereas woman has been programmed as monogamous. A man likes polygamy, he likes to have several partners, but a woman doesn't like several partners, she only likes one partner. This is natural. This is natural. If someone says, no, I like several partners, then she is going beyond her nature. A woman's nature is she likes only one person. A man likes several partners. That is why even though the country's law might be that polygamy is not allowed, but you will see these people committing affairs. So, because a man has been programmed in that manner. So, Islam restricted polygamy to four, because before Islam, in the era of Jahiliyyah, the people of Arabistan, who were wealthy leaders among them, they used to marry 10, 15, 20, 100 women. So that is why Islam restricted it to four and said, control your desires. When the nature of a person wants this, then when he goes in Jannah, Allah will fulfill his desire. And according to his rank in Jannah, he will get his fruits. Someone in a lower Jannah will get 2 hurus, someone a bit higher will get 72, someone higher will get 500. So whatever your rank in Jannah, according to that, Allah will give you your hurus and your rank in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said over here, وَحُورٌ عِينٌ كَأَمْثَالِ اللُّؤْلُؤِ الْمَكْنُونِ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوًا وَلَا تَأْثِيمًا. You will hear there no law and futile talks. You will not hear any sins in there. Meaning there will no quarreling, arguing, fighting, swearing, abusing, insulting in Jannah. Because before you get to Jannah, your hearts will have to be cleaned. Clean your heart in this dunya, so it doesn't need to be cleaned in the hereafter. Because if it's dirty and filthy in the Maidan of Hashar, then it will have to be cleaned in Jahannam. You will have to go to Jahannam first, punishment for your actions, clean yourself, and then you will be admitted into Jannah. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلِّمْ إِخْوَانًا عَلَىٰ سُفْرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. This ghil and this filthiness and dirtiness of the heart will be cleaned first, then you will be allowed in Jannah. So, لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوًا وَلَا تَأْثِيمًا. Not even among themselves, meaning with their spouses, with their wives. In this dunya, we fight among ourselves, husband and wives fight, quarrel, argue. But in Jannah, husband and wives will not argue. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوًا وَلَا تَأْثِيمًا. There will be no sinning, no fighting, no quarreling in Jannah. Illa qila salam and salam. Except words of peace, salam, salam. Peace and peace, peace and peace. There will be so much sukoon and peace in Jannah. This is the first category of Jannatis which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. The second category, wa ashabul yameen, ma ashabul yameen. The people of the right. And who are the people of the right? Fi sidri makhud, they will be in Venice, which will be large, like cherries. You get nice red cherries, strawberries, blueberries, blackberries. These are called berry in Urdu. Sidri makhud, they will be large, huge, massive. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Mi'raj, and he saw Sidratul Muntaha, and he saw that the leaves of that tree were as large as the ear of an elephant. And the berries of that tree were as large as the goblets of Hajar, meaning vessels made from Hajar. They used to be well known for their size. Large, huge, massive goblets were made in Hajar. They were brought from here. So the very small berries in this dunya, they were like that huge, massive goblets which used to come from Hajar. So like we have, let's say, huge, massive watermelon. So the berry of Jannah will be larger than a huge watermelon over here. For this is fisidri mahdood. Watalhim mandood and bananas, which will be one upon the other. Huge, massive bananas, and as many as you want, you can eat. But wadhilli mandood and shade, which will be stretched out. Shade, there is a tree in Jannah which is named Quba. Rasulullah said, if a fast horse rider was to ride beneath its shade, he could keep riding for 100 years, but still that shade would not finish. So huge, massive shade, and the whole Jannah is covered with shade, beautiful, because the Arabs used to like shade, especially when they're traveling in the desert, and they come upon an oasis. So everybody would run for a nice tree to lie down, sleep behind it, and relax beneath that tree. So Allah said, وَذِلِّ مَمْدُودِ Over there you won't have to fight for shade, the shade over of Jannah will be stretched out. And water will be poured for you as much as you want to drink. Beautiful, nice, tasty, sweet, chilled water, chilled drinks. And fruit in abundance. La maqtu'atin wa la mamnu'a, which will not finish. In this dunya we eat some fruit, it finishes. But in the akhirah you eat fruit, it will not finish. It will still be as much as it was when it was put in front of you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Jannah in this dunya while he was performing Salatul Khusuf. And in that Jannah, the Jannah was brought before him. Rasulullah moved forward and then he came back, retracted. After namaz, he said, Jannah was before me and the grapes of Jannah were brought before me. I went and I got hold of a bunch and I was going to take it for you and keep it over here. And if I was to take it and put it here, you لَأَكَلْتُ مِنْهُ مَا بَقِيَةِ الدُّنِيَا You would have ate from that bunch of grape as long as the dunya remained. But then I changed my mind and I left it as it was. So the fruit of Jannah will not finish. It will remain as it was when it was put before you. You keep eating and Allah will keep replacing it with kun fayakun. It will keep replacing there. It will la maqtu'a. Otherwise it will be cut off. وَلَا مَمْنُوعَ You will not be deprived of it. You will be given as much as you want. Nobody will say, no, you can't have any more. You can have as much as you want. لَا مَخْطُوَةٍ وَلَا مُنُوَةٍ وَفُرُشٍ مَرْفُوَةٍ The couches, the bed of Jannah will be raised high. In this dunya, we like good beds. I went to Canada, I went to my friend Shoaib's house. And when he took me to the bedroom, I needed some stool to climb on the bed. Because it was so high and it was massive, stretched out and beautiful like from the Mughal's bed. And so he put a stool, then I climbed on the bed. I said, yeah, I don't want to sleep here, I feel scared if I fall, then something going to break. He said, one of the Molanas from South Africa came and he was mashallah built, and he tried to climb on the bed, he couldn't, so he slept somewhere else. So in this dunya, we like huge, massive beds which are spread out, and soft, and kind, and nice, and you like it. So Allah said, وَفُرُشِمْ وَفُوَىٰ The beds in your Jannah will be huge, massive, widely spread out, and they will be high, and you can lie on them. When you want to lie on there, you won't need to climb on it with a stool. It will automatically come down. You sleep on it, it will go back up. Allah gave the misal in Surah Al-Ghashiya. Look at the afala yanzuruna ila al-ibili kayfa khuliqat. Camel, such a tall animal. But when you want to ride it, it comes down, you sit on it, it gets back up. This is why before it Allah mentioned wafurush, and then Allah mentioned camel. To explain that this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let you lie down and sleep on them. And inna ansha'nahunna insha'a, your wives will be created in there in a special manner. Faja'alnahunna abkara, we will have made them virgins. Urwan atraba, they will have extreme love for you. They will be infatuated with you. They will always dream about you and think about you. Atraba, and they will be of similar age to you. Inna ansha'nahunna insha'a, Allah has made them in a special manner. One lady came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She was an old woman. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, make dua that I go in Jannah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in a sort of joking mood at that time. And he said, no old lady will go in Jannah. Old ladies don't go in Jannah. Now, she was scared, she got up and she started crying. Rasulullah sent someone behind her and said, tell her, old lady will not go in the state of old age. She will be returned to her youth and she will go as a young, beautiful bride. Oh, is that what you meant? Now I understand. This is Inna Anshallah Unna Inshallah. When a woman reaches old age in dunya, her cheeks go inside, her teeth fall, she becomes poplin, and her eyes go inside, no hair falling off, and bones are cracking down. Happens to men, us as well, when we grow old as well, our bones start to crack and we get pain, arthritis, and we bimani, diabetes, sugar, blood pressure. In Jannah, there will be no sickness, no bimani, no old age. You will be strong, healthy, and Allah will increase your size as well, men and women. يَدْخُلُ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ الْجَنَّةَ جُرْدًا مُرْدًا مُقَحَّلِينَ أَبْنَاءَ 33 سَنَةً لَا يَقُولُونَ وَلَا يَتَغَوَّطُونَ وَلَا يَنْتَخِطُونَ أَمْشَاطُهُمُ الذَّهَبُ مَجَامِرُهُمْ الْأُلُوبَةُ رَشْحُهُمْ الْمِسْكُ عَلَى قُلُوبُهُمْ عَلَى قَلْبِ رَجُلٍ وَاحِدٍ عَلَى صُورَةِ أَبِيهِمْ آدَمَ 60 ذِرَاعًا فِي السَّمَاءِ. The Jannatis will go to Jannah in such a state that they will have no extra facial hair or body hair on their bodies. When we grow up in this dunya, we have beard, we have hair on our chest, on our bodies. But if you go in Jannah, these extra hair will be removed, we will have no hair. The body of a Jannati will be like a newborn baby. Only the hair on the head, no extra hair on the body. Nice, beautiful body. And you pass your hand over it, you like it. Beautiful body. So the Jannati's body will be similar, hairless, no extra hair on. Jurdan, they will have no beard. Awrat is someone with a beard. The indication is, beard is the sunnah of the Prophet. If you want to keep it in this dunya, you won't get the chance to keep it in Jannah. Keep your beard over here. Not only sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's also wajib. In Jannah, the Jannati's will be beardless, no beard in Jannah. So keep it in this dunya. Follow the sunnah and the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muddat, mukahhaleen. And your eyes will always be like someone who has applied kuhl and surmat. Naturally, your eyes will be beautiful. Every Jannati's eyes will be beautiful like he's applied surmat. Over here, if you apply surmat, it stains for a day or two and then it's washed away. But over there, your eyes will always look beautiful like you have applied surmat. Abna salatin wa salatin sana. Your age will be of 33. The best age, the medium age of a person is 33. Not when he's maybe 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. Not when he's 50, 60, 70. The medium age, the best age is 33. When a person is at his peak, his youth, his strength, his energy, his understanding, his wisdom, his intelligence is at its peak. So this will be the age of every generation. That age will never increase. You will always stay a person, a man or a woman of 33. There will be no passing water in Jannah. You won't have the need to go to toilets. وَلَا يَتَغَوَّطُونَ. No need to relieve yourself of istinja bekhana. وَلَا يَنْتَخِدُونَ. No blowing of the nose and no phlegm or balgam coming out of your throat. أَمْشَاطُهُمُ الذَّهَبُ. The combs with which you comb your hair will be made from pure gold and the special gold of Jannah. Imagine if the comb is of gold, then how will the rest of the furniture be? And majamiruhum al-aluwa. They used to take, incense burning, al-aroud and bukhul, like agarbatti. So the bukhul upon which whatever is to be, what you call, applied for the fragrance, that will be made from the wood, which is thought to be the best beautiful khushbu and fragrance in this world. And rashhum al-misk. When they drink water and drinks different drinks, they will not feel the need to pass water, urine, go to toilet. What will happen? They will have some perspiration will come out, and that's it, they will be released. Perspiration through sweat. And that sweat will have the smell of musk fragrance. Fragrance. And rashhum al-dhab, rashhum al-misk. And then Rasulullah said, قُلُوبُهُمْ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ رَجُلٍ وَاحِدٍ. Their hearts will be like the heart of a single person. There will be unity, ittihad, ittifaq, agreement among them. And he said, عَلَىٰ سُورَةِ أَبِيهِمْ آدَمْ سِكُونَ ذِرَاعًا فِي السَّمَاءِ. Your body will be enlarged to the size of the body of your father, Adam alayhi salam, 60 feet tall. Over here, we see a person 7 feet. 7.5 feet, he is the tallest man in the world. Adam alayhi salam was 60 feet tall. So your body is so that you can eat as much as you want, you can enjoy yourself, the pleasures of Jannah as much as you want. All men and women, rule and ladies and gents will be enlarged to that size so they can enjoy the luxuries and the beauties of paradise and Jannah. This is inna anshanahum insha'a. Fajalnahum abkara, urban atraba, li ashabil yameen. Thullatum min al-awwaleen, wa thullatum min al-akhirin. This is Jannah. The palaces, mansions of Jannah mentioned elsewhere. Jannatani min fiddatin aniyatuhuma wa ma bihuma fihima. Wa jannatani min dhahabin aniyatuhuma wa ma fihima. In other place, labinatun min dhahabin wa labinatun min fiddatin. Milatuha al-misku al-azfar, hasbaguha al-lulu, hashishu al-za'afran. Some palaces will be constructed in such a manner that they won't be bricks or stones. They will be made from pure gold and pure silver. The whole mansion will be of pure gold and pure silver. In some, one brick of gold and another brick of silver. And all the utensils in there will be also be either from gold or from silver. All the taps, all the beds, all the furniture, all the cups and cutleries and plate, everything made from gold. Or everything made from silver. And that gold and silver is also special gold and silver made from Allah by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unlike something better than the gold, miles and millions times better than the gold and silver of this dunya. There is no similarity between the ni'mat of Jannah and ni'mat of this dunya. The similarity is only by name. In fruits, apple, orange, banana, there is no similarity in the taste. The taste will be different. It's just to give us an idea of how the fruits will be, that these are the shapes and this is how they will look. The taste will be something out of this world. So similarly, all the Jannah mansion, even the cement between the bricks will be of al-miskul azfar. Al-miskul azfar, you know, very highly fragrant mush. And the pebbles in your pavement, which you have a garden and there are pebbles, the pebbles on your pavement will be rubies and diamonds and pearls and jewels. And the grass in your compound will be za'afran, always producing that beautiful smell. You go in hot climate countries and in gardens you pass by, there are flowers. You go in there and the whole garden is real beautiful, pleasant smell. In our countries, there is this pool called Rakhi Rani, meaning the queen of the night. It only lets out fragrance in night, not during the day. And if you were to go in that garden after Maghrib, oh, your mind would be fresh. You would sit there and enjoy. You would feel like sitting there and reading Kitab because your mind would be fresh totally. Because of the fragrance of that Rakhi Rani pool coming out and spreading every day. So, your Jannah will be in this manner. Beautiful mansion, beautiful palace, gold, silk, everything inside, and the rivers flowing in front of you. Not small, massive, massive mansion. Massive mansion. Because your size is massive, your mansion will be massive as well. إِنَّ فِي الْجَنَّةِ لَخَيْمَةً مِنْ نُبْلُوَةٍ مُجَبُّفَةٍ طُولُهَا سِتُونَ ذِرَاعًا. That one khayma, one marquee, which will be constructed for you in Jannah, the space and the expanse of that will be 60 miles. 60 miles. Imagine 60 miles from here to maybe somewhere, I don't know, Southampton, so far, Portsmouth, somewhere where. 60 miles. That how much one khayma and one marquee will be. So how big will be, how huge will be the mansions and palaces that Allah will give you in Jannah. These are the ni'mas of Jannah. Physical ni'mat. Something to eat, something to drink, clothes, you will be from silk, pure silk. Bareen and clean silk and thick silk, whatever you want. And all clothes will be from silk. This is why Allah has prohibited silk for men in this dunya. Permitted it for women, but men are not allowed to wear silk. It's a test from Allah. Avoid silk in this dunya, O men, and I will give you silk clothes in general. This is why men are not allowed to wear gold in this dunya. Avoid gold in this dunya and I will give you golden bracelets in Jannah. Over here, women wear golden bangles, golden bracelets. Men used to wear them as well. It was the custom of that time among the Arabs that leaders like Kisra, Khosrow, Qaisar, they used to wear golden ornaments, they used to wear golden necklaces. Even over here, the mayor of Portsmouth, Southampton will wear golden necklace. So the gold men like wear it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you that gold in Jannah to wear. Don't wear it in this dunya. So your libas will be of libasun fiha hadith. You halawna fiha min masabir min dhahabin wa lulwa wa libasun fiha hadith. Allah will give you all this, your libas, your clothes, your eating, your drinking. There will be no sleep in Jannah. Resting. You can rest in Jannah. Then Mullah Ali Qari said there will be time when the hijab will be lowered and it will become like sort of darkness and you can rest in it. You won't need to speak. And when that hijab is taken away, there will be light because there will be no sun, no moon, no stars in Jannah. There will be no heat, no zamharin, no cold, no freezing weather in Jannah. All one temperature. And you will be allowed to stay in that Jannah in your own beautiful life. These are the physical things you can think of. Allah will give you everything that you can dream of in this dunya. Allah will give you all that. You like listening songs? Don't listen to songs in this dunya. Your hur will sing song for you in Jannah. They will have beautiful voices. When they sing, your tabiat will be fresh and mazaa, orga, orga. There will be markets in Jannah. You will go around shopping. And you won't have to pay for anything. Everything will be free. And you won't have to carry the bags. The malaika will be with you. They will carry your stuff for you. And after you finish your shopping, there will be some places in which there will be forms. Forms, meaning bodily forms. And you go in that, and you like one form, and you want to change your appearance like that, you just go in there, you come out, you will look like that. There won't be any need for plastic surgery in general. You can make your face the way you want to. You can make your body the way you want to. Allah will allow you as the hadith of Mishkat Sharif. And you will go around. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call you all over in one arena. After your shopping, you will get together in one arena. And people will be sitting there. Some people will be sitting on members of mood. Others will be sitting on chairs of gold. Others of silver. Others of other things. Others will be sitting on Qusban al-Misk, the tilas and hilly areas of musk. Those sitting on the musk will not feel that those sitting on the nur mimbar are better than me. They will feel we are both equal, we are both close to Allah. They will feel that where I am is the best for me. And while they are sitting there, Allah will appear before them. Allah will talk to them. Allah will say to them, "Oh Jannati, are you happy?" And the Jannati will say, "Of course Allah, I am happy. Why should I not be happy? You've given us so much. You saved us from Jahannam, you admit us into Jannah. What else is there to ask for?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, "I will give you something else, something new." What is there to give Allah? And Allah will say, "Uhillu alaykum ridwani, fala asqatu alaykum ba'da Allah." I reveal to you my pleasure. I will never be angry or displeased with you. Okay, bhai. Bahar, Jannat is being opened up, and alhamdulillah, we have arrived at this place that you go shopping, you like everything, and everything. Among the greatest things of Jannat, the pleasures of Jannat, one of these is Ridwani, pleasure of Allah. And another is Ru'yat of Allah. Do you want to look at Allah over here or not? Of course, everybody wants to see Allah. Okay? But Allah said in this dunya, your eyes don't have the power to see. They need some special glasses. Okay? Then when the eyes get that power, then you will be able to see Allah. And that power cannot be given in this dunya. Allah will give you that power when you go in Jannah. Inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal himself for you. And as long as you are looking at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you won't turn to any of the ni'mats of your Jannah. You will just be amazed by the appearance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every Jannati will see Allah in his Jannah. We won't have to crowd, there will be no overcrowding, pushing, shoving to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, every Jannati will be relaxing in his Jannah and observing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are a few of the ni'mats and bounties of Jannah explained in Surah Al-Waqiyah, in many other surahs as well. We will leave Jahannam for the next time. Just stick to Jannah, inshallah. Tell me who in the flight to me says. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to to do those deeds and actions which take us into Jannah, inshallah. And may Allah admit us all into paradise. May Allah give us the shock of Jannah. May Allah give us the zeal of going into Jannah. And my dear brothers, we're just finishing off one last thing. We have to remember, Jannah is not cheap. Jannah is expensive. You have to pay the price for it. And what is the price of Jannah? Getting up at night for tahajjud. Muhurul hurul eid. Getting up at night for tahajjud salah. Will you get up for qiyamul layl, inshallah? Qiyamul layl. Get up for tahajjud. Qiyamul layl. Pray. Ask Allah. Oh Allah, give me Jannah to Firdaus. Give me Jannah to Firdaus. اللهم إني أسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل وأعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. Ask Allah. Also, price of Jannah is cleaning the masjid, removing dirt and kachra from the masjid, sweeping the masjid, cleaning the washroom, the toilet, washroom area is the price of Jannah. The house of Allah, you clean it, Allah will clean your heart, Allah will grant you entry into Jannah. Price of Jannah is sadaqah, charity, giving the path of Allah. Everything you give, Allah will multiply it and reward you by many fold in Jannah, inshallah. So the a'mal which you have to do, salat, sawm, zakat, a'mal salihah, sawm, we are going through the winter period. Keep fast if you can, because there is a special gate in Jannah for those who used to fast a lot. That gate is named Ar-Rayyan, Ar-Rayyan. From there, the Sa'imeen will be called. And when all the Sa'imeen have gone through there, that gate will be closed. Other people will go from other gates. And over there, they will be allowed to eat and drink freely as much as they want. Bishri Hafi Rahmatullahi Alayhi passed away. He died. After a few days, someone saw him in dream. That he is sitting there cross-legged and malaika angels are around him and the angels are feeding him. Someone is feeding him fruit and here and there. So the dreamer asked, what is this? Who is this at Bishri Hafi? Why are the malaika feeding him? And they said, the reply was, he used to fast continuously in the dunya, stay hungry and thirsty for the sake of Allah. So Allah ordered the angels to feed him over here by their hands. So these are the a'mal that will take us into Jannah. If you really want Jannah, you have to practice. And you have to practice. You practice, then you will get Jannah. And my dear brothers, just finishing off. You know, some people today talk about all these things, you know. Yesterday we were talking about signs of Qiyamah, Illuminati and Dajjal and all that. And they want to get a Qiyamah now. Don't talk in your mind these types of debates. Don't talk about it. What happens is it distracts you from Amal. You talk about it throughout the whole night and then you miss your Fajr. What good is that talk? Especially my youngsters, 20, 25 year old young ones. Don't fall for this trap. This is Shaitani trap. It keeps you inside that trap, confusion and chaos and that. And you worry about all these Imam Mahdi and that. You keep talking about it and you are distracted from action. That's not the work to do. The thing to do is practice, a'mal. Or, you know, go to sleep early and pray tahajjud namaz. Avoid sins. Okay, all forms of sins, major, minor. Be a good person, be a nice person. And Allah will give you Jannah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to practice. And may Allah be pleased with us. Show dua, muhtasar dua. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك المدين به نبي الرحمه كما تحب وترضى عدد ما تحب وترضى كل ما ذكره الذاكرون وكل ما غفر عن ذكره الغافلون ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار رب اغفر وارحم وانت خير الراحمين اللهم انا نسالك الجنه وما قرب اليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب اليها من قول وعمل يا ارحم الراحمين have mercy upon us oh Allah forgive our sins oh Allah you are ارحم الراحمين اكرم الاكرمين اجود الاجودين راحم المساكين يا الله you are the most gracious the most kind the most merciful we beg you we beseech you for your mercy we beseech you for your forgiveness oh Allah have mercy upon us forgive our sins Oh Allah, we have been talking about Jannah. Oh Allah, we want you to admit us into Jannah. Oh Allah, please give us tawfiq to stay on Sirat al-Mustaqim and do those a'mal which can take us into Jannah. Oh Allah, help us to avoid those deeds which take us into Jahannam. Oh Allah, protect us from the fire of Jahannam. Protect us from the azab of Jahannam. And give us all the ni'mats and bounties and blessings of Jannah. Oh Allah, give us your ru'yat and your diyar in the hereafter.
Allah, give us your ridwan and pleasure in Jannah. And give us all the bounties of Jannah which you have mentioned in the Quran and which your Prophet has mentioned in the Hadith. Allah, be pleased with us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon the whole Ummah. Remove all the problems and calamities from the Ummah. And Allah, have mercy upon the whole Ummah. And accept our humble du'as. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ صَلِّ اللَّهُمَّ وَسَلِّمْ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ بِرَحْمَتِكَ يَا
Thank you, Professor Mahbubi. Inshallah, we're grateful to Shaykh, inshallah, for spending time with us. Professor, I reminded that there are refreshments after the salah. Professor, I requested to stay for the refreshments after the salah.